Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're going to make Betty's made from scratch sloppy joes. We've already done sloppy joes on my channel, and that was called Extra Sloppy Sloppy Joes, and that's been a couple of months back. And we start with ground beef. This is 1 pound of ground beef, and it's low fat. It's very low fat, 4% fat. That means when I brown it on the stove, I really could put some of my vegetables in it and let them soak up any juice that there might be there, because there's just not going to be enough fat to skim off at the end. But what I'm going to do is treat it as if it's just normal hamburger and give the opportunity for skimming off the fat after it's browned. So all I'm doing at this point is putting 1 pound of ground beef in a deep skillet. It doesn't have to be deep. I'm trying to avoid some splatters on the wall here. And then I'm going to salt it. If you use 1 pound of ground meat, then you need 1 teaspoon of salt for that to be right. I'll turn this on and then I'll start browning this. And I do need to stir continually so that it comes out in little bitty bits, because when you have sloppy joe, you want to have it very finely mixed up so that it's not got big hunks of hamburger that you can't manage very well in a sandwich like that. So I'll see you back in a few minutes, and we'll put the other ingredients in, and then this will be cooking for a while, but it will be our made from scratch sloppy joe. You can see that the pink is all gone from this ground beef. And it's in very fine pieces. You can achieve that by cooking it slowly. If you're cooking it very fast, it will clump very quickly. You might notice that in the bottom here, I have a little juice, but it's actually not fatty. And I don't think I'm even going to pour that off. But this is the point where if you're using high-fat ground beef or hamburger, you would check and probably take several spoon worths and put them in a container and just get rid of it, because that's not going to do you any good. But this is ready for us to start adding our other ingredients. I'm just going to bring it over here and kind of explain what goes into this. This is my all-time favorite from scratch recipe. I've had it since, pretty much my whole marriage, and I will have been married 40 years next January. So this dates back for some time, but it's always my go-to from scratch recipe if I decide to make sloppy joes from scratch. We're going to add in 1 cup of chopped onion. And you see, I've got my kitchen chopper out here just to show you how easy this was. I have to clean that, but really running it under water is pretty much all it needs, and then to dry it off really well. But there's 1 cup of chopped onion. You need it really finely chopped, because remember, our goal is to make this into sloppy joes, and it's to go on a bun. And if you have big hunks of onion, you don't want them falling out of the bun. Same thing with the next ingredient. This is celery. I didn't use quite that much to make 1 cup of chopped, finely chopped celery. I put this here to show you the size of the onion it took to get that much. Actually, I had a little bit left over, so probably one that's a little smaller than that would work. So we put our finely chopped celery. Two nice ingredients to go in, and those will just cook down in a lovely way and just become part of the mixture. And next we have our 8-ounce can of tomato sauce, any brand you want. Just pour that in. Wait about stirring that for a minute, because I have some tomato soup. Any kind of condensed tomato soup, 10 3/4 ounce can. Just open it up, it's a pop top here, and pour it in. Do not add water to reconstitute this. It's condensed and you just leave it like it is. That goes in. And moving on down the line, I have some red hot sauce. So what you need is some kind of Louisiana hot sauce. And I shook this up, came out of the refrigerator, and I just want what you might call a dash, but it depends on how much you like this. My husband and I like it very hot, so I'm going to put a few dashes. Actually, it's not coming out. I think it's plugged up there, so I'm going to take this off. I'm not really going to pour, but I'm going to try to get a little bit. Well, I think I can unclog that. Maybe that will do it. We'll see. Oh yeah, it's coming out now. That's a good dash. Okay, so that's enough hot sauce. And then the last ingredient is chili powder. I've measured out 1/2 teaspoonful. If that's too much for you, then use 1/4 teaspoonful, but it needs a little zest. And we've given it some here, and we're giving it some here. So it's a really nice blend of flavors that we're going to cook up. And when I put this back on the stove, after I get it stirred, we will let it just simmer for 30 minutes. And then we'll have this luscious, made from scratch, sloppy joes. And I'll try to serve it a different way this time, just to show you some options that you might have instead of doing the coleslaw and tomato slice deal like we did last time. See how nice that's looking right now? Well, it's gonna look better when it's done in about 30 minutes. My sloppy joes are done. You can see that they're simmering away back here on the stove, but I'm gonna turn the heat off and remove them. And this is the consistency that you will expect. I've got a slotted spoon here actually, but when I pick up some of this, nothing goes through it. So I can use it as a serving spoon. It should be that thick. So coming over here, let me just show you what you might do to serve them that's a little different from what we did before. My number one choice would be the way we served them before, which is to have a whole wheat bun or a white bun, doesn't matter, put a big, generous spoonful of this on it, the sloppy joe mix, then put coleslaw on top of that, and then a big slice, thin slice, of tomato on that, and then cap it off with the other half of the bun. Here I've chosen Kaiser wheat buns, so on the bottom I might choose to put the sloppy joe mix. And it's going to be sloppy. It may come off the edge there. And then on the other bun, maybe some sandwich spread, or if you prefer, it could be mayonnaise. Nice and generous, because when these flavors blend together, it's kind of like that creamy coleslaw going with it. So that's probably why I like it. So we could do that, and then maybe just add a few slices of tomato around here. Whatever looks good to you. If you like a lot of tomato, then do it that way. And then we need to get these together. So there's one way you could do it. Something else you could do, start with the bottom of the bun and put our sloppy joe mixture on there. Nice generous portion. And then maybe think Mexican style on this. So I might put some shredded cheddar. And if you have someone in the family who's brave enough, then you can add some jalapeno slices to the top of that. Now on this other one, you might want some either sweet pickle slices or dill pickle slices. So I'm just going to add those to the plate. Put the cap on here. And usually we have these when we have my daughter and her husband and my 3-year-old grandson. So we have to have a little treat, like maybe Cheetos or some snacky type thing on the side. Something like that. And then a glass of iced tea. We're all set.